He's been a strong and often loud voice for the Waimanalo community, and now he wants to do the same for veterans. A recent brush with death has inspired him to make a difference for those who have fought for our country. He credits a fellow veteran for saving his life. Ron Mizutani reports.
Andy Jamila has served the Waimanalo community as an advocate for decades. Before that, Jamila proudly served his country.
When they asked me to pick up a rifle, I picked up a rifle. Asked me to pick up a machine gun, I picked up a machine gun. Asked me to get in a 60-ton armored vehicle, tank, I got in it.
Sergeant Jamila was honorably discharged after serving 6 years in the U.S. Army. He returned home, where he became a fixture in Waimanalo. About a month ago, while working out, Jamila noticed he was struggling to breathe. Several days later, his condition worsened, and he was rushed to Castle Medical Center.
When they took the blood from my arm, they looked at the blood, and it was like 98 motor oil.
Doctors told him he was on the edge of death. 90% of his heart was not working, and he needed immediate quadruple bypass surgery. That was the good news.
The bad news is, if you don't agree to this procedure, we could be coming to your funeral.
Jamila was told he needed to go to Tripler Army Medical Center for services, but there was no guarantees that a room or even a doctor was available. His doctor feared he would not survive a trip over the pulley.
I could have a major coronary going over the hill.
That's when Jamila reached out to Congresswoman Tulsi Gabbard.
The risk of moving him anywhere else was something that no one should have been willing to take. So I was glad I got my team and we started working with the VA and others, bringing multiple people together to be able to make sure that he got the benefits that he has earned as a veteran.
Representative Gabbard helped organize for Jamila to receive immediate medical care at Castle Medical Center.
When they come home and they face challenges themselves, our nation owes a debt of gratitude to them to make sure that they are taken care of, that they are served, and that they get the benefits that they've earned through their service to our country.
Jamila is now back home, more than 50 pounds lighter, but recovering from surgery. His heart is working at 50%, and with proper diet and care, doctors say he can make a full recovery.
A lot of veterans are homeless on a beach. Maybe they'll see this, and they'll call in that they need help.
I'll do everything I can as a citizen, as a veteran, as a member of Congress to be able to make sure that our veterans are honored and that they are served no matter where they go.
There's nothing on the triceps or biceps now. I mean.
But you're alive.
I'm alive. I'm alive.
A strong voice for Waimanalo is now a strong voice for veterans. Reporting from Waimanalo, Ron Mizutani, KHON 2 News.